Sam, relay to the Tempest that we're stranded but alive. No choice but to investigate PB's signal.
Pathfinder, this console controls the gate.
Things stoke the fire in a pirate's dark heart like buried treasure. In update 0.1, there could be riches hidden beneath the sands of any island out there on the open sea. But all great adventures begin with a promise. And that's where our maps come in. When you embark on a treasure quest in this update of the game, you'll have a map to get you sailing in the right direction. In this case, a classic X marks the spot style map. You and your crew will be relying on this map, first to pinpoint the island, then to dig up the treasure. Making this a little bit easier is the map table on your ship. This gives you a wider view of the many islands you can travel to, and your ship's position on the sea. By comparing the islands on both maps like some kind of ingenious pirate detective, you can plot a course and get your treasure hunt underway. Ideally, at some point you'll make it to the right island, and face one more test of your crew's cartographic skills to track down the buried stash. There won't really be a giant red X in the sand, so you'll have to use the island's landmarks to find your way. Just like birthday celebrations and riding a seesaw, digging for treasure is much more fun with someone else. And the more of you who help to dig, the faster you'll uncover the bounty. But that's only half the voyage. For the real reward, you need to get the chest back to an outpost and cash it in. So while one pirate hauls the treasure, the others should escort them back to the ship, watching for any sly rivals who would love to score some treasure the easy way. Back on the ship, it's up to you to find a good hiding place for your precious cargo. There's still a chance that some enterprising sea dog will sneak on board and snatch it, but don't make it easy for them. Of course, the seas can be treacherous, and your crew will have to work together to reach a safe haven, fending off rival crews if they get too close. This could be a chance to test your blunderbuss or pistol by boarding their ship, to engage in a friendly exchange of ideas. If, after all this, you eventually get back to an outpost with your ill-gotten gains, head to the shipwright, who'll happily exchange it for gold. Well, maybe not happily, but she will exchange it. One quest, well and truly smashed. This is just a first glimpse of what's to come in Sea of Thieves, and we look forward to showing you more as we set sail through our technical alpha phase and beyond. Cheers!
Conan Exiles is an open-world survival game in which you use the freeform building system to craft yourself a village or city, which you then use as a base to fend yourself. In order to dominate your enemies, you're going to need to create a safe location, a place that you can store weapons, supplies, a place which you decorate and you invite your friends to show off, a place where your clan can gather to discuss their war plans. These are things like forges, armor-making benches, woodworking benches, tanneries,
We have a huge selection of placeables and decoration. You have tables and shelves and barrels and candles.
You can craft gongs and horns, which you then you can use to signal the approach of your enemies or to let your friends know to open the gate. You can kill some of the hardest creatures in the game, chop off their head and have that mounted on the wall of your living room.
Some of those decorative pieces are also little toys. Like, for example, you can place an archery target that you can shoot at and it will give you a score depending on how close to the bullseye your shot was. Thralls are another major component of crafting.
When players start to get into the thrall system, they'll be able to go out into the world and capture artisan thralls. And once you place, for example, a Stygian smith at a Stygian forge, suddenly you have access to Stygian weapons because his knowledge becomes your knowledge.
You can attack other players' structures. Depending on the tier of the structure you're attacking, some weapons are going to be ineffective. You can also craft explosives that you can use that affect all tiers of building. When you plan your base, you should also make sure you have enough space for an altar, and you need altars in order to unlock the religion path.
The avatar is the ultimate expression of your religious fervor in the game.
When facing enemies with the ability to summon avatars, it pays off to think on your base layout carefully.
When one of them steps on your city wall, it's going to crumble. They say home is where the heart is, but in Conan Exiles, home is where you keep the hearts of your enemies.
Welcome to your first look at Identity Player Housing. This here is an apartment in Ash Hill. It's still not quite complete. We have a little more work left to do on interface and such, but even as it is, it's the most complete player housing I've ever seen in MMO. This inside is a two-bedroom apartment, which means it can house two people, the owner and a friend. It starts off a little bit basic with low-level trims on the walls and such, and laminate flooring. All this can get upgraded. Almost everything is interactive, like this TV can be turned on, streaming YouTube videos.
Oh my god, what the fuck happened?
Alright, do me a favor. Call FSA Chebiz or something. He's in the beginning of the list and tell him that ASDFZ needs that help we were talking about, alright?
Now, almost every one of these items are crafted and customized. That sofa that you see there, it can be made in leather, different colors of leather, fabric, all sorts of different ways. It's up to the designer. And this is a bookshelf is sort of a special container, so it can hold items like other things, but really it only holds books. And what's cool is when you put books in there, they're actually visible right on there. And this, now notice how this can't be placed anywhere except near that power receptacle. Now let's just fill in a little more furniture. Dining area over here will make it look a little more complete. So we have dining tables, and that's going to need a chair too.
Identity is all about giving absolute freedom in a world that's full of other people and fun things to do. We've gotten rid of most of the AI and replaced it with people. It's people who are driving down the street, and it's people who run for governor. It's people who play as police officers and fight crime. You'll find sports, car racing, paintball matches, and more others than I have time to list. And if living off the land is your sort of thing, you can make a pretty good living hunting or fishing. Identity is all about the freedom to do what you want to do when you want to do it. While Identity is an MMORPG in most ways, we're going to be offering you the option to rent your own servers too. So if you want a different, more specialized style of gameplay than our official servers have, such as maybe hardcore role-playing or some kind of like endless action, server operators are going to have control over hundreds of features to customize what they want.
Сюжетные локации рейда – это различные зоны города Таркова и его пригорода. Индустриальные объекты, транспортные развязки, крупные участки леса, спальный район, коттеджный поселок, маяк и, безусловно, центр города. Везде игроку придется находить способ выбраться из изолированных участков, последовательно приближаясь к зонам выхода. Разнообразие локаций заставляет игрока прибегать к различной тактике прохождения, а большое количество объектов для исследования поддерживает интерес к возвращению на эту локацию снова и снова. Динамическая смена времени суток и погоды уже упоминалась ранее. Время на серверах идет с четырехкратным ускорением, чтобы игроки успели за одну сессию заметить смену времени суток. Также в погодной системе можно настраивать облачность, плотность и высоту тумана, направление и силу ветра, силу дождя и вероятность грома и молний при грозе. Погодная система постоянно дорабатывается и улучшается, было добавлено процедурное намокание объектов, появление лучших капельного оружия. Эффекты времени суток и погоды могут выглядеть иначе при использовании солнцезащитных и тактических очков, давая как плюсы от их использования, так и минусы. Всего мы планируем 10 основных локаций плюс несколько скрытых дополнительных, одну фрироум локацию и две локации для режима арена. Каждая рейдовая локация по-своему уникальна и зачастую будет необходимо возвращаться до них, чтобы выполнить те или иные задания. Где-то предстоит работать командой, где-то можно будет попытаться пройти в одиночку. В последних рейдах игроки будут сталкиваться с продвинутыми дикими и даже беглыми ЧВКшниками, которые выбрали путь бандитизма. Процесс производства локаций – это один из основных приоритетов работы команды моделлеров и левел-дизайнера. Сейчас идет проработка самой амбициозной и масштабной локации из всех – это центр города Таркова. Улицы, здания были спроектированы с нуля. Большинство из них будут полностью проходимыми, чего стоит только 10-этажный гостиничный комплекс и 12-этажный бизнес-центр.
Star Citizen is an epic first-person experience spanning hundreds of solar systems where players can fly highly detailed spaceships, battle on foot through massive space stations, explore life-sized planets, and discover adventure in an ever-expanding and changing galaxy. It's a game I've always dreamed of making, and with a community of over 1.6 million, we are well on our way to making the dream a reality. The biggest module is the Persistent Universe, known commonly as the PU. You can fly solo or crew up your ship with your friends to explore, dogfight in ships, or battle on foot. This represents the first glimpse of what will ultimately be the massive multiplayer Star Citizen universe. So what happens from here? Well, we're continuing expanding the PU by adding more planets and even more star systems to explore. Our new dynamic mission system will allow players to choose their own path in the universe, from bounty hunters to space pirates, traders, mercenaries, miners, explorers, and many more. As all these new pieces began to fall into place, the universe of Star Citizen will really start to come together. But even then, it will only still be the start.
Victory! There can be no survival!
Imagine a game without limits. A world where you can build anything, from spaceships to orbital stations. Explore, craft, trade, and conquer. all in one universe, shared by everyone at the same time. Forge your collective story. This is your world. Rebuild civilization together. Dual Universe. Support us on Kickstarter now.
To be seen, as nothing is ever simple in these kind of scenarios. Okay, so we've arrived at the mission area, and normally snipers work in pairs, with a spotter who detects targets and measures the distance and wind. But John is deep inside enemy territory without backup, so he has to act as his own spotter. So the first thing we'll do is find a good vantage point and scout out the location ahead. Remember that higher ground is not always the best place to be, as you need to have an exit route in case of an alarm. You don't want to be stuck in a tower or under enemy fire with no way out. After neutralizing this enemy, we have a clear path for the drone to fly it to the CCTV box and disable it like Lydia told us to. Here's one of the targets off our most wanted list, who have committed the most horrendous crimes against the Georgian people. Whenever we find them, we can take them out to gain additional rewards.
Someone asked me once if I remembered how it all went down. As if it happened so long ago that anyone could forget. So yeah, I remember. I remember when our homes and our towns turned into graveyards. When the wilderness became our only hope for survival. I remember when the planes fell out of the skies. When the trains stopped running. When the turbines shut down. And the world went dark. I remember when they put up the razor wire. Like it was gonna stop anything. When the feds ran out of body bags. And some of us sort of lost our minds.
I think he's dead.
Some lost more than that. Much more. I remember when we lived by a code, when brotherhood meant something, and living meant more than surviving.
Goddamn liar!
So yeah, I remember how it all went down. I don't give a damn about any of that. You know what I remember most? Riding the open road. The smell of your hair. The touch of your skin. I remember you. But those days are gone. Now I'm a drifter. A bounty hunter. A mercenary. And for me, the broken road is all that's left. But I'll always remember.